Welcome to another episode of House Entertainment Sessions. I'm Jason Dudley, and I'm well happy to present to you today, ENT Fostell. Today we are joined by ENT Fostell. How you doing today?
Yes, sir. What's happening?
Very well. So let's start off by telling me, how long have you been a DJ for?
We're looking about 20 years or something like that.
20 years?
Yeah.
20 years as ENT Fostell?
Most of it was DJ Naughty, and then now more like I'm ENT Fostell for the last 9 years?
Last 9 years.
Yeah.
All right.
Meant to be. running away, and it's not gonna change. There's nothing you can do for me, so what's the use? Not gonna stick around, nothing to figure out. I gotta say farewell.
One for the, but for those who doesn't know you, do you consider yourself to be more than just a DJ?
Yeah, definitely, 100%. I'll consider myself to be more as a producer now.
What makes that transition for you? Like, what makes you feel like that?
Less DJ bookings.
Less DJ bookings and more productions,
yeah,
in the studio.
More productions, yeah, more releases and everything.
Love.
sparked your interest in becoming a DJ in general?
Pirate radio. I used to be like in my room with nothing but channels 1, 2, 3, 4 and Fuzzy 5 and a radio. Yeah. And then afterwards, I listened to radio more than I watched TV.
Triggered you to make the first steps? So we get it, like living in the household, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and that. But like, what made you buy your first set of decks or your first record?
My first record, I used to go to school near UDM in Enfield.
Okay.
So, yeah, I used to see that record shop, go in there, then go Fat in Caledonian Road, just collect records all the time, and then ask my parents if I could get a set of decks, and yeah, they got me Technics.
Music was you into growing up?
Initially I was into rap, obviously Michael Jackson, R&B and all that kind of stuff. And when I was into pirate radio, garage, 100%. Okay. Bumpy, energetic, always lively, rough with the smooth actually. Sometimes it's a bit hard and other times it's a bit, but like, not slow, but soulful, if you know what I mean.
We'll be right back.
specific within genres. What type of genres within house music do you play?
You know what? It's a fusion between, you know, tech house, but on a more bumpy vibe, deep, but also like a soulful vocal vibe as well. But it's not exactly soulful house. I've actually called it wave house because it's like got that kind of R&B vibe to it as well.
Moment as a DJ so far?
I can't even really think. Maybe probably flying to different countries like Ayanapa, Germany.
Absolutely.
So yeah, Sweden as well.
One time for the girl in the back with the back. Just like that, like that, like that. One time for the girl in the back with the back. Just Time for the girl in the back with the back.
I'll say social media, you know, like when there's social media, it's a very loud world and you can't be silently brilliant. So you have to be loud as well. So I'm a very quite reserved, I'll say, you know, laid back person. I'm not really that loud. So being loud, yeah, I think that's a big hurdle for me.
Give it to me.
Tell me three things you love about playing to a crowd. Doesn't have to be free, just name me one. Like, what's your most favorite thing about playing to a crowd?
Well, that's when I kind of express myself a little bit more. Like, behind the booth is the only time when I really express myself. Like, I'm dancing, I'm vibing, and seeing the crowd kind of, like, you know, react to it. That's kind of the best thing, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, totally.
So, yeah, they bounce off me, if you know what I'm saying.
Hard one, but could you tell me your top three DJs of all time, any genre?
Yeah, EZ, Kenny Dope, and Jazzy Jeff.
Respectable.
Down with the all 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 down
what DJs are you listening to at the moment? Like, who's really capturing your ear?
Honestly, I've not been listening to any DJs lately. Like, I've not really had the time. I've always been in the studio, so I haven't really got the chance to listen to other DJs at the moment. The regular, like Defected, always check what they're doing, sometimes Spinning, even the majors actually, like there's always something there, but it's not even specific labels, it's just artists or what's out there. I don't really look just for specific labels, I just look to see who's out there and what artists I can actually get as well.
Excuse me.
as a producer, could you tell me what your biggest track to date is?
Every single track's got its purpose, I'll say, because my first release as in Fostell was like, you know, people's eyes were like watching what I was gonna do, but I couldn't say which one's biggest because all of them are like kind of like a tool. Like Circles got big because of Idris Elba. He did a remix, and then I did a track with MK that went quite well. And my last release has like broken boundaries for me, so I can't really measure which one's the best. It's kind of like measuring success, and you can't really measure success if you're not. Hey,
sitting next to someone quite often who can say I've worked with Idris Elba and I've worked with MK. But saying that, have you got any dream collaborations? And well, I feel like you might have already done it.
Yeah, it was MK actually. To do something with him was a big deal, and like it was on my bucket list. But I wouldn't say dreams anymore. I'll say there's artists that I would want to work with. Like you see them R&B artists like her, SZA, Doja Cat even. Like if I could get in the studio with them, that would be amazing. And to me, that's just like at fingertips reach now.
I just want to confirm, mentioning names like that, would it be to cross over and do like their music, or would it be to bring them over to the deep tech? Sorry, not deep tech. I hate that word. Sorry. Sorry, don't shoot me.
House.
Like the house world. End of.
Yeah. I want them on my world. But it'll be in their integrity as well. So, yeah. Keep it, you know, vibey. Something that they could sing to with the chords and everything. But, yes, them come into my world.
As a DJ, what is your mission, your aim, or like what do you hope to achieve, like your lasting legacy?
As a DJ, not so much as a DJ, more as a producer.
Okay.
Like to bring those artists to my world. Like, so it's like breaking barriers again.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's my biggest dream, and bringing a lot of new artists as well.
Yeah.
Like seeing them go from, you know, homegrown to worldwide.
Yeah.
And yeah, me being the catalyst for that.